Have you ever wondered how the Slack slide-in menu animation works? Well, in this tutorial, I am going to show you just that. Alex here from Rebeloper, and in this tutorial, we are going to build out a slide-in animation. So I want you to hit that subscribe button, open up Xcode, and let's dive in. So let's take a look at the beautiful side menu that we are going to build out today. So I'm just going to build and run this demo project that I have created, and this is it. Now, this view controller that you can see here, this will just slide over. Now it's not going to slide, the menu will not going to slide over the main view controller, it's going to push it to the right. And of course, this grayish view, you can may add anything that you want, a list, a UI table, view controller, whatever you want. Okay, so let's build this out. So we are going to start from scratch as usual, and I'm going to create a new project here. And let's go app, let's create next. Oh, by the way, let me just resize this. So I just selected app, just so you know. Let's just remove this out of the way. Awesome. So let's have this as a side menu. Okay, and make sure that you select storyboard and UI kit app delegate and of course Swift. Let's click on next here. And let's just go over here and let's select some other place here. Okay, and let's click on code, create. And I will create a GitHub repository on my Mac so you can take a look at it later on. Go ahead and click the link in the description so you can see where the GitHub repository lives. Okay, so first thing first, as usual, let's remove the main.storyboard because I don't like to work with storyboards. So let's take a look at this. Let's remove the main interface. Also in the info, let's just remove the application scene menu first. Go ahead and move all the way down here till you see storyboard name and remove that with the minus button here. So what we need to do here is just go ahead and initialize it in the scene delegate. Let's do that real quick, because if you are an avid follower of my channel, you already know this. And if you don't, make sure that you hit that subscribe button and make sure that you subscribe. So Windows scene, I just got a little mumbled there, but yeah, we want to create a Windows scene and our window should be initialized as a UI window with our window scene. So there we go, window scene. Awesome. And now we want to make this window scene key and visible. So window scene dot make key and visible. And now we want to set the root view controller. And as you already saw in the example, we need the UI navigation controller. So we are going to instantiate it right over here. It's really convenient. And with a root view controller, and our view controller will be our root view controller. Okay, so let's go back here and let's see. View controller, let's just add in here our view. Let's see, dot background color equals, I don't know, maybe system teal. Okay, so let's build and run. Not on my phone, but on a simulator. And let's see how this looks like. And finally, we are going to add in some menus. There we go. System teal. How awesome is that? So let's take care of some stuff here, like setting the title and setting the left bar bottom item. So yeah, this should be, now let's just change this to system background, why not? And let's set the title to be side menu. Okay, and now we want to create a left bar bottom item. So to do that, we are going to create it inside a lazy variable. So lazy var and menu bar button item. Okay. Let's just have here some more space so we can see that. And that will be of type UI, or let's just instantiate this. So UI bar, come on, UI bar button item. There we go. And we are going to use the one with the image, style, and target and action. Okay, so let's go with the image. And we are going to use a system image, so UI image and system named. And I'm going to use something called sidebar dot leading. This is in SF Symbols 2.0. And because I don't want that bluish tint color, I'm just going to render as original. So with rendering mode dot original, always original. And the style, it could be done, why not? And the target is self, and the action, pound, selector, and let's name this menu bar bottom item tab. So menu bar, there we go. So we need to create this objective C function, and let's do that. So in a new line, let's create this at objective C function, func. There it is. Really, really nice. Now, all we have to do is grab this menu bar bottom item and add it, set it as a left bar bottom item. So right over here, navigation item, set left bar bottom. And we are just going to, let me just copy and paste this. It's really a bit quicker. Animated false. We don't really care about the animation. So let's build and run and see how it looks at the moment. So really, really nice. Okay, and we can tap this and whatever. So what we are going to do here is that we are going to set, so add a subview for the menu, and then we are going to add another subview on top of that for our container. So yeah, basically that is what we are going to do. And whenever we tap on this, we are going to kind of slide the top away and slide it back when we want to hide the menu bar. So it will look like some sort of, okay, we're going to slide in the menu, but actually what we are doing is sliding the top container layer. So yeah, let's just create two views here, and I'm just going to copy this out from my notes here because yeah, it's a pretty self-explanatory. So I'm just going to add those right over here. And we here have a menu view and a container view. Now, what we want to do with these two is just add them and align them to our view. And for those, I'm just going to add in here some extensions on the UI view where we can add those views to its container view. So I'm just copy and paste that here. And I will just go through them. So what we have here in this is an edge to view. What we are doing is adding the subview, adding the view, the self, to our view that we added here as a subview. We are setting translates auto mesh resizing mask into constraint to false, and then we are constraining it to all of those anchors. So top, top left, right, and bottom. Now here is the pin menu to view with a constant. Now, what this does, and you just go through it, you will see that here, the trailing anchor is not equal to the trailing anchor. It has a constant value, and it's minus that constant that we added here. So it will pin it with a constant, and we are going to use 40 here, but you will see that in action. Okay, so what we want to do now is just simply add the container view and the menu view. So first of all, we want to add the menu view because that will be on the bottom of the stack here. So let's see, menu view dot, and I'm just going to use pin menu 2, and the view is the view, the view controller's view, and the width, let's have a new constant here, and I will name this constant slide in menu padding. So all the way up here, let's just create that lazy var, and I'm just going to tell you in a second why that lazy would be a lazy variable. Slide in menu padding, there it is. It needs to be a CG float, and now we are going to use the widths 30%. So self.view.frame.width and multiplied by 0.30. Okay, so that would be 30%. Of course, you could use a constant like 40 or whatever, but yeah, this is really, really handy. So what we are going to do is copy this out, and because we need to access self, that is why it needs to be a lazy variable, by the way. Let's copy this out and paste it in there. So let's see how this looks like, okay? It won't be, you won't really see too much, but yeah, that's how it is. It's the system background is here and the system gray 5 is here. So really, really nice. Now we want to add the container view. So container view pin, and I think it's edge. Yes, edge to view, and that is our view. And of course, you already know this will take care of everything. Now we should see just a simple white background. So it's on top of our menu view. So next up, we want to set up the logic on the menu bar bottom item tab. And yeah, this is where the magic comes in, and we are going to animate it. And let's just start typing in and you will understand how this looks. But before we do that, let's just create a variable on top of this is slide in menu pressed. So let's create a var and is slide in menu pressed. And that will be false because presented, sorry, because the slide in menu isn't presented just like, or the side menu, whatever. So let's just go over to our menu bar bottom item tab and let's create our UI view. So UI view.animate, animate, and just use the one with the longest one, basically, with duration delay, using spring, with damping, initial velocity, and so on. So with the duration, 0.5, I found it really good. Delay, 0, using spring with damping, 0.5. This is kind of the damp, the kind of bouncing effect on the view when it's completing. Initial spring velocity, that should be 0. Options, now, ease in and out. So ease in out, it's a really nice option for the animation. And now we here we have our code and our completion. Now for let's take a look at the completion first. So finished. So finished. So whenever this animation is finished, let's just print out animation finished. And let's add in here our finished. And once the animation has finished, we want to toggle the is slide in menu pressed. So self is presented, is slide in menu presented dot toggle. Okay, so what do we want to do here? Well, basically we want to set the origin of our container view. Well, the X origin of our container view. So let's just type this out and you will understand. So self.containerView, containerView.frame.origin.x. So it will grab the x value of our container view's frame. And this should be either 0 when it's in place or just pushed away. So how do we do that? First of all, we want to check if is sliding menu is presented. So go ahead and type in self. Is sliding menu presented? Question mark. If it's presented, then we want to move back and set the origin to, x to 0. Otherwise, we want to go ahead and self on the container view dot frame, grab the width of our container view and remove the padding that we just set up in the lazy variable dot slide in menu padding. And basically that's it. Let's just build and run and see how this looks like. And there it is. And there it is. And as you can see, we have our animation did animation finished to true. Let's show that again. Slide in, slide out. How awesome is that? Go ahead and add any labels or whatever into the container view or the menu view. Now it's your turn to add this awesome slide in menu navigation into your apps. Now, if you did like this video and you do like my teaching style, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring where I can coach you one-on-one. Now, if you did like this video, then go ahead and hit that notification bell, because in the next video, we are going to talk about UI page view controller. That's right, we are going to swipe through those pages. While you wait for that, make sure to check out these videos as well too. I talk a lot about Swift UI, Swift in general, and UI Kit. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.